What's up, guys, and we have a very special speed test comparison today. The absolute best of Samsung, the Galaxy Z Fold 2, goes one-on-one against the best of Apple, the iPhone 12 Pro Max. These two devices are the most expensive phones from each company. Of course, the Z Fold 2 just completely breaks the bank with its $2,000 price, but rightfully so because of this huge innovative design. It has the best unboxing experience as well. You get the 25-watt charger as well as the AKG headphones right from the box, and just such a premium experience overall. It's been 2 weeks since I've been using this, and it has completely changed the way I use my smartphone. The iPhone 12 Pro Max is here, and I feel like these two phones will be my main phones for the next few months. So I thought, why not do a speed test comparison between the two of the most expensive, two of the most fastest devices on the market. Now, this is the first time I'm doing a speed test comparison of a foldable phone, so it's really exciting, honestly. As always, we're gonna start this test off by booting up both phones at the same time. Here we go. We've got the Z Fold 2 5G logo first. And let me just quickly transform this into its ultimate film. Such a huge, huge display. Okay, so the iPhone 12 Pro Max boots up quicker. Of course, that Apple A14 chip running the show. Now we are in position, and guys, look at that difference of technology. Starting from next year, the Galaxy Z series will become the star of the show, even more popular than the S and the Note series. No device on the market can do what this phone can do. This seamless transition between a phone and a tablet is just incredible. Of course, one day Apple will do the same, but that day will probably gonna come like in 2023. Or something. Anyways, let's get down to the business. Starting off with Apple's own application that I use on both phones, and that is Apple Music. So launching in 3, 2, 1, go. And you can see that was really, really quick on both devices. Of course, the Z Fold 2 gives you a lot more screen area to play with pretty much any application. And it's also rocking 120Hz refresh rate. Just feels incredibly smooth. Next on the list, we have Instagram. And that is definitely faster on the Z Fold 2 or Z Fold 2. This is the latest feed, a bit quicker here. And once again, Instagram running on the Z Fold 2, you get so much screen area to play with. Scrolling looks really, really good. Once again, 120Hz here, 60Hz on the iPhone 12 Pro Max. Let's check out my profile. That is faster on the Galaxy Z Fold 2, slightly quicker once again. And let's launch this post. Seamless performance, even with this new kind of aspect ratio, the Instagram is running really, really good. And once you actually get used to this kind of screen, it's kind of hard to go back to the traditional smartphone. Let's see the opening speed of the Insta camera. And feels slightly quicker on the iPhone. Spotify, slightly quicker on the iPhone 12 Pro Max. Quora, faster on the Galaxy Z Fold 2. Really, really smooth performance thanks to the 120Hz. Twitter, and faster on the Z Fold 2. Bit of a different feed, but quicker on the Galaxy Z Fold 2. Now let's go ahead and launch some games. We have Subway Surfers on both phones. And that is really quick on the iPhone, but the Galaxy Z Fold 2 is not behind, not that far behind. Let's just quickly get into the game. Asphalt 9, one of my favorite games to play, especially on the Z Fold 2, thanks to that big, big display. Completely optimized to run on 60 frames per second as well on both devices, but feels a bit more immersive on the Z Fold 2. Okay, so the Galaxy Z Fold 2 actually faster in terms of loading this particular game. And now we have the iPhone finished up. Now time to play a similar game on both phones and see the in-gaming loading times. And that's also quicker on the Galaxy Z Fold 2. So A14 might be more efficient. Obviously, it is efficient, 5 nanometer, but Z Fold 2 just takes the cake in both loading times. Once again, having that huge tablet display at your ease is just really, really incredible. And top of the line performance on both phones. Reddit. And that's quicker on the iPhone 12 Pro Max. Next up, my favorite app of all time, the YouTube application. Here we go. And definitely quicker on the iPhone 12 Pro Max. Color switch. And felt a little bit quicker on the iPhone. PUBG Mobile. And both phones actually finished this off almost at the same time. And feels like the Galaxy Z Fold 2 is done. iPhone is playing a promo here. Both phones can run this game on Ultra HD with extreme FPS enabled. With that, let's quickly check out the performance real quick and see how the game runs with all that awesome graphics enabled. Okay, that was about the same time on both devices. Let's first try it out on the iPhone 12 Pro Max. Looking pretty good, actually. Playing this game on Ultra HD really sets the mood. All that sharpness. You can see the detail everywhere, and it runs pretty good on the iPhone. Definitely not sharp 60 frames per second, but yeah, it's probably around 50. Still feels very, very smooth. Not a lot of devices can run this game on full Ultra HD graphics. Now let's go ahead and try it out on the Galaxy Z Fold 2. Wow, first thing first, that huge display offers such an immersive experience. A lot more screen area means I'll be comfortable to, you know, shoot around, touching those buttons. Let's jump and this is incredible. You can see why anyone would get addicted to a foldable smartphone. And of course, you know, you can actually play this on its outer display if you want that, but the inner display is the main highlight of this phone. Okay, we just landed and wow, this just looks so immersive. Really high detail thanks to that Ultra HD settings. You can see amazing performance, no lag whatsoever. Highly recommend it on any of your flagship phone. And just another quick look on the iPhone 12 Pro Max, looking pretty good. Pretty sharp detail with the grass and everything just pops out of the display. But of course, if I have to pick one phone, that would be the Z Fold 2 easily because of this huge display. Now we're just gonna leave this here and launch some more applications. Let's do some video rendering in Adobe Rush application. And time to load up the same video on the timeline. You can see that was actually faster on the Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 2. And thanks to that amazing Snapdragon 865 Plus chip, you can see just scrolling through the timeline is really, really smooth. And we can do the same thing on the Apple A14 powered iPhone 12 Pro Max. Let's apply some color grading LUTs on both phones, adding some text graphics as well. And let's export this video at 1080p resolution. And of course, I still think that the iPhone's A14 chip will be faster, as I've seen this in comparison to the Note 20 Ultra. But yeah, this is just to completely see the limits of the chip. And of course, we have all those apps open in the background as well. You can see the iPhone is done. Z Fold 2 is still almost halfway done. So rendering is just too OP on the iPhone. Still, I would say larger display, it does give you more of a comfortable experience if you wanna do editing on a mobile device. And after 20 more seconds, we are done on the Galaxy Z Fold 2 as well. Let's go ahead and now, last but not the least, we're gonna be launching cameras on both phones at the same time. Here we go. That's definitely slightly faster on the iPhone 12 Pro Max. Now time for a quick browsing test. We have WWE.com on both phones. And let's see, both phones were really, really quick. Seems like the iPhone is definitely faster here. Once again, that smooth scrolling effect with the Z Fold 2, thanks to 120Hz, just makes the experience really, really amazing. We've got one more website, that is Samuel.com. And the Z Fold 2 this time around seems like that's about the same on both phones. Once again, very, very smooth performance. Even with the larger display, it's keeping up pretty well against the iPhone. Now time to check out the RAM management and see if the Z Fold 2 is keeping every app in the memory. This is the first time I'm checking out the RAM management on the Pro Max. I've seen great performance on the standard iPhone 12 Pro, so I feel like it should be able to keep everything in the memory. And I expect the same on the Z Fold 2 because of its 12 gigs of RAM. Let's see, moving on to Spotify, still there. Quora, Twitter, Subway Surfers, that is still there. S Fold 9, seems like that is completely refreshed on the Z Fold 2, so iPhone is also refreshing, but that was an in-app refresh. Reddit, still there. YouTube, color switch. PUBG Mobile, both phones are still keeping it in the memory, as you can see. Premiere Rush, and we are back to the browser. So yeah guys, that was a very fun speed test to do. Again, I just wanted to test out the performance of the Z Fold 2. I've never actually done this before, so that was a fun experience. Once again, Z Fold 2's ability to transform into phone and a tablet is just magic to me. So it's gonna be in my pocket until the Z Fold 3 comes out. And the iPhone 12 Pro Max will definitely going to be my main iPhone. It's having a huge display as well. I love the big screen size. Let me know your thoughts about this in the comment section below. And yeah, I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out.